These days there are many pretenders to his throne, but very few, if any, who feel that they could actually topple Arlen Ness into obscurity.
I'm usually building at least 6 bikes at a time. I mean, I've always have, where you have things started all the time, so you know you're waiting for parts or you're going to have this done so you can jump over and work on something else, and it makes it nice so you have something new coming out you know every quarter, you know, every half a year, and it's something new, so it's good for the PR and the magazine articles and to kind of keep your name out there. I've tried a whole lot of different things, from the antique look to the Bugatti look, to the full-bodied bikes. I started to try to bring the drag racing look onto the street. Kind of always stuck to the long, low bike. That's kind of always been my trademark. I always liked that look. I would probably say, if you asked me which my favorite bike would be, of course, my first knucklehead, which I still have. I cherish that. But as far as design-wise, the smoothness bike that resembles an early Bugatti is probably right up on top there. The body bikes were real good in the 80s and the early 90s, the smoothness and the Chevy bike. And before that, the double-engine Sportster was very popular. That went all over the world.
It's not surprising that Arlen's twin-engine Harley has been shown around the world. Built in the 1980s, it was possibly the most outrageous motorcycle ever seen. It was all done in the worst possible taste, but it stopped people in their tracks, whether stationary or on the street. And yes, you could ride it. Arlen never builds a bike that can't be ridden.